One of the most common initial places of metastasis in breast cancer is to bone. Bone and skin and lymph node would be on the better end of metastatic sites that tend to have better responses and more options for therapy. The worst sites of metastasis would be such as sites such as liver and most especially brain. Unfortunately, whenever we have a recurrence of breast cancer in a distant site such as bone, we are dealing with a situation that in all likelihood is not curable. There are individual instances of cure, maybe in about 1% of such cases, but for the most part, we're looking at a palliative situation in the sense that we want to provide treatments that maximize lifespan and, of course, minimize toxicity. Since cure is not a goal, again, we want to use treatments that are least toxic. Very commonly, bone metastasis come from a hormone receptor positive breast cancer, and in that case, one should exhaust all anti-estrogen or hormone-based therapies before moving on to chemotherapy. This would be such medications as the aromatase inhibitors, or tamoxifen, or Zoladex in the premenopausal situation, or Faslodex in the postmenopausal situation, and then other hormone therapies such as progestational agents or even high-dose estrogen. Only when hormone modalities have been exhausted or the tumor is known to be hormone receptor negative does one then go on to chemotherapy. Fortunately, in metastatic breast cancer, there are 6 or 7 different drugs, most of which are fairly effective, and most of which are actually not overwhelmingly toxic. These would include drugs such as Halaven, Navalbean, Gemzar, Zoloda, and several others. In the situation of bony dominant metastatic breast cancer, one would most likely go with a single chemotherapy agent, only if a person has very rapidly progressive visceral or lung, or meaning lung or liver metastasis, might one consider combination chemotherapy in the metastatic setting. So one would then run through a series of chemotherapy drugs and obviously hope to get some good response out of each. But unfortunately, in metastatic breast cancer, one ultimately finds that the cancer becomes resistant to the modalities that we have. And at some point, further chemotherapy becomes more harmful than helpful. And at that point, it would be to the patient's best interest to back off on any aggressive chemotherapy and consider comfort care or hospice.
Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.